Opposition leader Peter Dutton has taken aim at Penny Wong's calls for the recognition of a Palestinian state. In a speech at the Sydney Opera House last night, Mr. Dutton labelled the move reckless and blamed Labor for a rise in anti-Semitism in Australia.
Opposition leader Peter Dutton has delivered a scathing review of Labor's leadership in his speech at the Tom Hughes Oration at the Sydney Opera House.
That something is rotten in the state of Australia.
It comes just one day after Foreign Minister Penny Wong outlined the government's perceived intent to recognise a Palestinian statehood.
The two-state solution is the only hope of breaking the endless cycle of violence.
Mr. Dutton used the opportunity to respond, and he didn't hold back.
It is the most reckless act of a foreign minister I've seen in my 22 years in the parliament. The foreign minister not only implied that the Albanese government is prepared to recognise a Palestinian state, she had the audacity to blame Israel for the failure of a two-state solution.
He believes Ms. Wong's comments have weakened Australia's international standing.
For a crass domestic political win, Penny Wong has damaged our relations with our ally Israel.
Taking another swipe at Senator Wong and the Albanese government, Mr. Dutton accused Labor's lack of leadership for its role in the rise in anti-Semitism within Australia.
The Prime Minister and members of his government have downplayed the unprecedented level of anti-Semitism afflicting our country by dishonestly treating it as analogous with other forms of prejudice. And what remains is a national moral fog which has made anti-Semitism possible. Foreign Minister Penny Wong made that moral fog denser last night.
The opposition leader was also highly critical of the government's response to the protests that took place on the steps of the Opera House following Hamas's attack on Israel on October 7, even going as far as to draw comparison between the protest and the Port Arthur massacre of 1996.
Whilst no one was killed during the protests on October 9, thank God, the events at the Sydney Opera House were akin to a Port Arthur moment in terms of their social and national significance. In my judgment, Prime Minister Albanese has not risen to that moment as John Howard did.
Christy Lloyd, Sky News.